So a solar flare is a disruption of the sun's magnetic field that occurs over a sunspot, and the coronal mass ejection, CME, is a thing that happens along with the flare. It's the actual matter that's coming out into space. Now, in general, it doesn't go in the direction of Earth, because, you know, the sun doesn't really care too much about Earth. It's going to go in some random direction. This particular flare we're talking about right now actually left the sun on Monday, October 7th, and this is an X9 class flare. It's connected with other flares that actually left back about 4 days earlier on October 3rd. It's predicted to cause very severe geomagnetic storms. So there's kind of a thing going on here where you have the plasma reaching Earth. This is charged particles. The particles do not reach the ground. We're not going to get fried, but they get caught by Earth's magnetic field. And they basically kind of ring Earth's magnetic field like a bell, and then you get these waves going all over the place in Earth's magnetic field. That's a geomagnetic storm. So at the moment, we're really worried about radio blackouts and power grids interference. But for us here, probably nothing more than an enhancement of the northern lights. But it's important to keep in mind that solar activity is ramping up right now. We're in what's called solar cycle 25, but that's also coinciding with a maximum of a very long-term scale variation of solar activity that goes over about 100 years. The typical solar cycle is about 20 years, but we're having a peak of both the 20-year cycle and the 100-year cycle right now. The thing that we're really worried about a little more long-term over the next few years is the possibility of a much stronger event of the scale we haven't seen in a few hundred years, a so-called Carrington level event, which was, we last experienced that in 1859, back when we had the telegraph system, and it basically burned out the telegraph system. So if we were hit by something like a Carrington level event from 1859 now, then you're talking the internet down for weeks to months, maybe, probably power grids down for at least days to weeks. The really good news is that the sun's not going to sneak up on us and do this, because we always see the flare first. We'll see that ring of brightness, and then we'll be able to observe the coronal mass ejection. We'll be able to estimate how large it is, take about 24 hours to reach us. We'll have that long to run around and unplug stuff and disconnect generators from the grid, put satellites in safe mode, turn on hospital generators. In other words, we will have some warning. So there are protocols in place to deal with that. And everything will be okay as long as it's not too big an event. It's a pretty rough cosmos out there, and this is just one little example of, you know, how dangerous space can actually be and how we have to try to prepare as best as we can.